top jerseys, when we talk about the iconic jerseys that we've seen, which ones come to mind for you?
I'm gonna have to put ours aside, because that's the all blue.
It's a lot of blue. It's a lot of baby.
You can never have.
Like the whole point is double blue.
You can never.
And it might need to be single blue now.
Never have enough blue.
But it's just one type of blue essentially.
No, if you look carefully,
Oxford helmet, Oxford jersey, Oxford pants.
Look carefully. There's some accents there from Cambridge.
Okay.
All right. So top of the list definitely going to be the Toronto Argonauts. I think we got the best colorway. You can argue that and debate that as much as you want in the comments, but to me, that we're at the top. I like the Montreal Alouettes. And you know what? They got somebody over there doing some real good work.
You like the Alouettes now?
Definitely now.
Okay.
Definitely now. They're New Jerseys. I think they've been doing a really good job when it comes to branding and changing it up. You're talking about the iconic jerseys?
Of all time.
I also like the old Alouettes. Well, they had the wings on the
yes.
Shirt. I was feeling the old.
The Ocho Cinco.
The grays. Yes. When Ocho came back. Yeah. Cup of coffee.
Yes.
Those were pretty elite. Those were legit.
That era of jerseys, was it the Signature Series?
I think so. That's when they were starting.
Those were strong. Even Hamilton had the grays in that era.
Honorable mention.
Sure.
Winnipeg Blue Bombers, Royal Blues.
Okay.
Remember those?
I do.
Well, yeah. Pretty good. Got to wear those a couple times.
I still see those in the stands.
Yes.
I love the Memphis Mad Dogs. I love that era when the logos were, it always looked like a hockey sweater. The logos were so big. And I like big logos. I loved the Argos era where Jason the Argonaut was just the whole shoulder pad. That it was like almost like true to life was his face on the shoulder. Those, the Robert Drummond specials, if you will. BC, around the Dave Dickinson, Casey Printers era.
Okay.
When they had the big paw print and the big logo on the shoulders.
Okay.
Notice I like big, but I like throwback. The Riders, the Centennial uniforms. Mm-hmm. The old school look. I think the Canadian Air Force rocked those. Those would be the ones that stand out to me. And then another throwback is, we're used to it now. It's built into the colorway. But the first time the Stampeders went black and had a black uniform. And they came with some new helmets with black and silver. Those Stamps unis were tough.
The BC Lions also did that one year, didn't they?
Yeah.
I don't think the whole league liked it. Because I remember we were watching film and
couldn't
see the names. Well, I got to get rid of those. They're disadvantaged.
There were some play-by-play people who were upset. You couldn't see the nameplates and the numbers, but hey. All in the name of swag.
Amar wasn't in the building yet.
All in the name of swag. It doesn't matter.
He would have thought about it.